desserts, right? But sometimes it's hard to justify that last bite of sugary goodness. Well, today we have Luke Hines in to show us how to make a dessert that is not only super yummy but super healthy. Welcome to the show. Last time you were on the show, there was a bit of an incident, wasn't there?
Oh, yeah, we should probably go there.
You remember? A spatula?
I do. I haven't been able to forget.
Why did you use the spatula on the hot pan?
You see, I'm the quintessential home cook. I like to show people, you know, no training, no expertise, just get in the kitchen and give it a go.
Let's have a recap if you missed it.
Great example of really good fats.
Is that a hair in there? What's that?
I don't.
Oh, what is that?
Oh,
it's not a hair.
It's a string.
It's a string.
It's the ingredients.
The spatula.
Oh, the spatula is melting. Is it?
The spatula. The spatula.
So that no spatulas are harmed in the cooking of today's recipe, I've come with a very firm, stiff wooden spoon. This is not melting. Now, speaking of stiff wooden spoons, we're actually making chocolate balls that pretty much explode when you put them in your mouth.
All right, fantastic.
So, they're really good for you, let me guarantee you that. So, the first thing we want to do is redemption for the chocolate. Okay. So we're going to melt down raw cacao butter.
Now where do you get this stuff? Because this seems like a
look at
very...
That.
Yeah,
amazing.
It really goes quickly, doesn't
it's
it?
It's like chocolate lava.
And health food stores?
Health food stores, yeah, not your supermarkets. This is more of a health food store type thing, but most health food stores should carry it.
Why must you use that one? Why can't you just use normal butter?
Okay, the reason you wouldn't use normal butter is a combination of the flavour. You won't get a chocolate flavour with normal butter, but also normal butter won't necessarily set at room temperature. As you saw in this packet here, it was really firm.
Yes.
It's firm at room temperature and hotter, which means when you make raw chocolate, you can pack it in school lunches without it melting.
Great.
A lot of people make raw chocolate with coconut oil, and that's another one that melts when it's
quick.
A little bit warm.
Okay, so what else do we add to
our cacao
butter? So
we add raw cacao powder, all right, so we're going to add that in there as well. Now we heat this on a medium to low heat because we don't want it bubbling or boiling. If you burn raw cacao or raw cacao butter, it can end up with quite a bitter flavour.
Okay.
So what we want to do is we want to keep that really nice and chocolatey and smooth.
Smells lovely.
Now, Ida, you're doing a very good job. I love it. I feel very privileged that you're helping me cook my recipe. Sweeteners. Let's talk sweeteners.
Yes.
So I'm using...
Because sugar's the enemy, isn't it?
Well, look, we want to minimise sugar and we want to minimise processed and refined sugars. So today we're using maple syrup. You could also use honey. And if you're trying to avoid fructose, you could use rice malt syrup. Now, do you love that the spatula's not melting here? That we've stuck with a wooden spoon?
I'm sure it would add flavour, but I prefer wood.
Yeah. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get the maple syrup through there. Now, just try to use things like honey, maple syrup, or rice malt syrup, and they're going to be the most
complex sugars.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Okay.
So the next part of the recipe is all about my favourite flavours. We've got raspberries in here, and then we're going to add some shredded coconut into that mixture there. Now you don't have to add any sweetener to this mixture, but I like to just to bring out a little bit of more flavour there because raspberries can be quite tart. So what we want to do is we want to bring a little bit of sweetness in there as well.
A bit more maple syrup.
Now, because we want these balls to be firm, what we're going to do is we're actually going to add a little bit of coconut oil to that. Now, this one, when we put this mixture in a fridge to set, it's going to harden up so that when we mix it into the chocolate, we get a beautiful chocolate coating with a semi-firm kind of raspberry filling, if that makes sense. So in here, we've got raspberry, shredded coconut, little bit of maple syrup. We've got coconut oil in there as well.
Going to give it a mix.
And we're rip-roaring and ready to give it a go.
I'm glad
you took that out because that was going to be a disaster.
Yeah, it was going to be a disaster.
Waiting to happen. So what you want to do, you get a stick blender like this, or you could use a food processor and put everything in like that, but I like to get my wrist into it. So we're going to give that a bit of a mix-up. Now, I'm a bit of a messy cook.
I think that's good. It's called rustic cooking.
Yeah, rustic. All you need is a bit of mess, serve it on a breadboard, and it's rustic.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. So mix that up, and as you'll see, I don't know if the camera can... Oh, the camera's in there. It's close. It's a sexy close-up. You're seeing how beautiful this raspberry mixture comes.
Yeah.
Now, the coconut The cacao butter and the cacao powder is melting down beautifully. Okay. What we're looking for right here is to make sure all those last pieces of the raw cacao butter are melted down completely. Okay. And then we know we're ready to go.
Okay.
Then we remove it from the heat so that it's not super hot, because we want this a little bit cooler, this nice and cool, so that when we roll our balls and we add it to the chocolate, it coats really beautifully.
Okay. We have been making chocolate raspberry bombs with Luke Hines. So just in the filling, you've got some raspberries that we've zhuzhed up with some coconut butter, maple syrup.
Yep, that's exactly
coconut.
Right. Desiccated
and
coconut.
It looks like there's glitter on
there. They're very sparkly balls. So what we've been doing in the ad break, we've been rolling a bunch of balls, and all we need to do, when you get them to this point, what you want to do is you want to stick in a toothpick or a skewer like so. Mm-hmm. We're going to set these in the fridge for about 10 to 15 minutes so they firm up. Now what that lets us do is in the non-TV land, we pick them up on that skewer, and then what we would do then is, because they're very cold and firm, we would put them in the chocolate. Now, but for today's purposes, I'm gonna cheat it a little bit. And what I'll do is I'll just coat this one a little bit, because it's cold. It'll set on there a little bit, but you're sometimes doing two rounds of this gives you the double chalk-coated balls, which is really delicious. So what you do is you just get those, you put them back onto the tray as such, and you repeat that with all of your mixture here. So roll lots of balls, put them into the chocolate, set them back in the fridge.
How long for?
Oh, it's like they're done in 10 minutes.
Oh,
it's the best recipe.
Yeah.
They're
and
really good.
Here's some we've made earlier.
Oh, hello.
That's fantastic,
look at this.
Sarah.
So you're saying this would be great. Everyone take a ball.
Yeah, take a ball.
Are we allowed to?
Yes.
Oh, I'd love you to.
Okay. Now, you said these would be great in kids' lunch boxes. How long would they last in the fridge for if you made them up on a Sunday?
In the fridge, they're going to be really good for a week, and then you can freeze them, and they're good for up to a month, which is fantastic, because for me, having a healthy household is all about cooking.
Oh,
yes.
No, they're lovely.
Are you sure? It's about cooking in bulk. Do you like them, Sarah?
I love them.
So just to clarify, Luke, if someone comes up to me and says, can I skewer your balls?
Yep.
I have to say, wait till they cool down first.
I can't imagine yours ever cooling down.
That's right. On that note. That's
right. And you've got a new cookbook?
I do, guys. Thank you for having us today. Healthy Made Easy. It's in stores now.
You've got to come back on the show more often. We love you.
I'd love to. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.